Hello everyone, and welcome back to the second lesson of this series I'm making. Today I'm very excited about this lesson because it was one of the biggest problems I had. It's one of the biggest problems I had in the academy. How to stretch your paper properly. Let me tell you a little bit about what kind of papers do we use and how do we start and how do we proceed with the papers. In the beginning, we use Roma paper. Roma paper is especially designed for pastels. So it's not a good paper for watercolor. Roma paper is heavy, is handmade, and you can stretch it easily unless you fold it super tight or you damage it in a way. After Roma paper, we continue with watercolor paper and usually the artist paper. Why? Because Roma used to make gray paper, green paper, brown paper already toned. But now we can't find it, at least in Spain, and as far as I searched on the internet, they have it only in the factory in small quantities. So we need to tone our own paper, and in order to tone a paper it needs to be watercolor. Some people told me that they toned Roma paper in the past, but a friend of mine actually tried it and failed. At this moment I don't have a Roma paper here in Greece and I cannot find, so I haven't tried it to tone it. But I'm going to show you the way you tone and stretch a watercolor paper. Today I'm going to show you only the stretching part. And on the next video, I'm going to show you how to tone it, what value do you use, and how to mix it and everything. Okay. I remember in the academy when I was doing my second crust, Apollo, I lost almost one day, and the people in the academy, actually, my classmates, were laughing about it because I stretched the paper almost six times with no luck. Because maybe the paper took some moisture, I don't know from where, or maybe I did something to damage it, and it was always a little bumpy in the middle, so I couldn't work. So I had to change papers and re-stretch it again. So I was super curious about how professional artists stretch it, and there's no problem. So I searched everywhere, I searched watercolor forums, watercolor videos, everywhere, and I think I found a solution. Today here I have two papers. The one is Sonder Waterfort. I think I'm saying the name right. It's hot pressed and it's 185 grams if I'm not mistaken. And the other one is the classic artist paper that we use, watercolor, fine grain. And it's also 185 grams. There's also the 300 grams artist that we use mostly, but this is also a very nice paper to work with. I'm going to use the artist paper for the toning video because I have only one left, which is white, and I want to actually use it to show you the toning. I will show you the stretching with this paper, which is also watercolor paper, to get my point. So, as you can see, the paper is already folded like this. They ship to me like this from a place here in Greece, which is not a very good way to ship paper, but we can fix it. So we're gonna need the paper. We're gonna use gum tape. This is called gum tape, and you can find it in the proper art stores. Here in Greece, I haven't found it anywhere, as far as I searched. But I think for the people in Greece, they can find it in the framer stores, because they used to seal the frames with this. So if they go to a framer and ask him for a gum tape, maybe they have it. So gum tape works like that. It's not sticky now. So you need to put water on the shiny surface to activate the glue and then stick it wherever you want. We're going to use cup of water, some demakeup pads. You can use also a brass or whatever you want, but I actually like to use this because I use one and then I throw it in the trash. Because if you take a brass and you brass the glue, then the glue some glue passes to your brass, and if you don't wash it properly, it's stuck in a very annoying way and you cannot get it over properly. So I use this and it works very good so far. We're gonna use also 4 pins, the classic pins, the office pins, I don't know, we call that like that in Greece. I will show you why. A hammer to slightly tap the pins onto the paper, and a board. I will stretch my paper on this board. This is not a board for drawing, because it's very heavy, super big, and very thick. Neither this is a drawing board, because as you can see, with the way we're going to stretch it, it creates a lot of tension to the surface. And if the surface is not thick enough, it's going to create this bend. Something we don't want. So a proper size for a drawing board is something like, I don't know which I should show you. I don't know if you can see this, no? It's probably something twice the size of this, the thickness, and from a better material probably. Okay, so let me recap everything. We want to stretch watercolor paper and not any kind of paper. So this technique I'm going to show you, it's only for watercolor papers. I've never tried it to Roma, so I don't know if it works. I hope it works, because I actually love Roma paper. So you cannot do this technique in every paper, every kind of paper. So if you go to the art store and you buy a paper and you put it here, in the classic cubes we have to carry out our papers, the paper at the end is going to look at best like this. So even if I open it, it's a heavy paper. So it's not I open it, I fold it and it's okay, or I use the classic artist tape, tape it, and it's going to hold. It's not going to hold properly. It's going to create something like bumps, something like my t-shirt, for example, like when you do this, it creates a not a steady surface, so it cannot hold properly the charcoal. And for example, with the long poses that we're doing, and it's like 5 weeks long or 4 weeks long, you're gonna draw, you're gonna take your drawing board up and down to your studio, it's gonna get a lot of tension, a lot of charcoal, it's gonna get softer and softer and softer, and the artist tape is not a strong tape, everybody knows that. So we need to create something stronger and more safe for us to work. As you can see, I have all my materials here. I already cut 4 stripes of gum tape, 2 for the width, not exactly the width, a little bit more to the sides, and 2 for the length. Okay? So, the technique works like that. I'm gonna take the paper, I'm gonna put it under the shower, you heard me correctly, under the shower, and I'm gonna actually take it for a bath. The whole paper, the whole paper is gonna be fully wet with water. It's a watercolor paper, it's made for that reason, so don't be afraid to actually wet it. I'm not saying put it in the bathtub and leave it for the night. We're gonna wet it for 1 minute tops. So it's gonna get moist. And then, this is a water activated tape, as we said before. So, we will have the paper wet. We're gonna wet the tape. And then, we're gonna stick something wet to wet together. And we're gonna leave it flat on the surface to dry. When it dries, it's gonna dry flat on the surface, stretching also the tape a little bit. That's why we're gonna use in the corners, in the four corners of our paper, the pins, in order to secure these four corners at least. Another thing we're gonna use, probably, is a towel. A towel to get rid of the excess water after we wet it. So, I'm gonna change the camera position now to go to the shower to show you. And we're gonna get back here, after the we wet the paper, to show you how I'm gonna do it. See you in a while. Okay, as you can see, I'm inside my shower with the paper. I'm gonna open the paper in the water in cold, and then I'm gonna wet the entire paper. I don't know if you can see. Okay, that's enough. We're gonna go back and see, and I'm gonna show you how to stretch it. Okay, so now I have, as you can see, a paper towel on my board, and I'm just tapping a little bit for the excess water to go away. I'm folding it. I'm putting on the other side also. One more time. And I think that's okay. So, now I'm putting my paper where I want it. And then I'm gonna take the gum tape I have already cut. I'm gonna take the makeup pad, I'm putting it into the water. And then I'm gonna put water only in the shiny side. Not on both sides, I'm gonna dip the whole thing. Because if you put on the whole thing, it's gonna get off after a while. So, I put into one already. The paper is wet. And my tape is wet. So I'm putting the tape on the paper. And I press to get it unified. And we continue with the other three stripes. Sorry about the setup, but it was the best I could find. Okay. Last two. Okay, now we have four of our sides tape of our sides ready. And the last part, I've seen some people doing it, and I just want to show you. You take these pins, and where the folds are from your gum tape, you put slightly one pin in each side. Okay. So now the only thing left is for the paper to dry along with the gum tape, and as you will see at the in a little bit, the paper will be completely flat and everything is going to be ready for drawing. See you in a little while to actually see how the paper did. Welcome back. As you can see, it's our paper is completely stretched, and we left it about 30 minutes dry only. And if I lift it, you can see that it's a perfect flat surface with not even bumps, nothing. So now you can leave it to completely dry for the night or for as many hours it takes. You can remove the pins afterwards and you can start drawing. If by any reason the gum tape is not properly attached to the paper, or because of the tension when the paper starts to dry, lift some gum tape off, you can easily take an artist tape and just tape this place a little bit, not like stretch it and spend a lot of time on it. It's already stretched properly, so you don't need to worry about it. If you have any questions or another way, a better way perhaps, to stretch watercolor paper, feel free to write in the comments below. On the next episode, I'm going to show you how to tone watercolor paper and stretch it at the same time. What value you should use to tone it, and some other tricks and tips. Thank you so much. Enjoy your drawing.